Feel that look on me, man. I'm not being an asshole. I'm being smart. No lights, no, you know, they can't see us. Christ, I can taste blood in my mouth. I don't think it's mine. I can't see a damn thing out here.
I guess that makes sense.
Yeah, it makes sense, Wyatt.
God, I can't believe we're in this shit.
Don't barf just yet, okay? Please? This road is really straight. We'll be fine.
At least slow down.
What? Fuck no. Did you see that one guy's eyes, man? He is fucking gorked. I don't want that guy in my life, Wyatt.
Dude, you are covered in that guy's blood.
I know, Wyatt. My shirt is soaked. It's like, I just... Why didn't they say anything? Guy's taking his shit over there. That's all they had to say. It's bullshit. Look, Wyatt, all I know is those guys had me all jacked up, like I was on speed or something. I was just on edge, you know? Then I was like watching that guy's brains come out of the back of his head. Sorry, man, I...
Well, thanks for getting us out anyway. Let there be light, huh?
Dude, shut up. See? It's fine. Road straight as my dick. You think we're in the clear? Are you still thinking about my dick? All right, let's Tom Cruise out of here.
Why is it that you never had a girlfriend again? Oh, right. Forgot there was more than one reason.
See if there's still any sticky in the glove box. Wyatt, come on, man. Check the glove box.
I don't see anything.
Dude, it's in there. Look harder.
I don't see it. What I do see is that ammo that you lost last week.
Oh my God, really? But is there any weed? You know, one time I was going out with this girl, right? Abigail. You remember her? And she told me that when she was 5, I think, her dad took her to the circus sideshow. They walked around for a while, saw the chick with two heads, saw a dude with lobster hands, some kind of monkey human with a dick for a face. I don't know. She also said there was a little girl in there the size of an apple. But I called bullshit on that one. The point is, she saw there was this guy standing in there, buck naked, and singing this weird... Are you even listening to me? The guy peed on her dad. Shit! Ah! Holy shit, dude. Holy shit. Did you get a look? I think that was a guy. Wyatt, come on, man, say something. Was that a dude or not? What the fucking fog? This night is so fucked, man. Wyatt, talk, Wyatt. Do you have to be so damn thoughtful all the time? Have an opinion.
Let's see if there's anything around the car. You know, anything that'll like tell us one way or the other. That way we can just book. But I'm not leaving if we hit a human being, man. I'm just not.
Man, don't roll it down broken.
I can't see through the cracks. Look, it's fine, see?
Dude, what's that on the broken side mirror?
It's part of a shirt, I think.
Yeah, but plenty of dead guys have shirts on. Keep looking.
You think that blood on the windshield is fresh or rotten?
Does that blood look fresh to you?
Yeah, but it's kind of dark.
Yeah. Damn.
What's that way out in the road?
Is that the mirror from the car?
Can't tell from here. Man, I'm really not seeing anything.
Look, Wyatt,
It was a guy.
Are you sure?
Yes.
How sure?
Pretty fucking sure. Don't fuck with Tiny Carlos, sure.
Jesus. So what do we do?
What do you mean, what do? We go out there.
Go out there and what?
Find the guy and help him. Who the hell are you tonight?
If it's a guy.
It's a guy. I saw him. Come on, man. This is stupid. We go out there, we check it out, we get moving.
Both of us?
I mean, I don't know. Me? I hit the fucking guy. One of us should stay here, though, in case. Okay. Well, shit. Okay. Here, we'll rock, paper, scissors for it.
Fine.
Okay, cool. Good. This is good. We need to hurry up. You ready?
Man, I can't believe I'm doing this shit.
Dude, 2 seconds, it's over. All right, 2 out of 3, right?
Sure.
1, 2, 3, go. Shit. All right. Okay. All right. 1, 2, 3, go.
Ugh.
I knew you'd pick rock. You always pick rock, dude. It's stupid. All right, dude. This is it. Shit. 1, 2, 3, go. Paper is a loser.
Son of a bitch. All right. I got this.
Be careful, dude.
You gotta hurry up, dude! Shit. Are you okay? Sir? Can you hear me? Damn it, man, are you gonna be alright? Fucking help me out! Whatever happens, I won't let you turn into one of them things, man. Trust me, Al. Yeah, that's probably not helping. Sorry. Okay, fuck it. All right, let's get your ass to the car.
Ah!
Should probably hurry.
Shit, shit, shit.
Maybe this dude can give me a ride. Maybe.
Bang! I just killed you. You're either stupid as fuck or you think you're tough shit. Or both, I guess.
I need a ride, you got a ride.
You willing to work for it? I got needs. You know what I'm saying? I'm just fucking with you, man.
Okay.
So you have some balls on you just standing there like that. You'll get killed eventually. Ain't none of my business.
I won't...
What's your name?
Russell.
So you didn't steal that bag. I don't care who you steal from, if you did. Maybe you're in a gang that likes to rob people. I don't know. Are you in a crew? You got some boys wearing hoodies I gotta worry about? Because you steal from me and I'll get your throat out. I don't care who you run around with, you understand?
I'm not in a gang. It's fucking racist, man.
Hey now, I ain't no racist. I just call them like I see them. Just get in the car. You're gonna get eaten out here otherwise and I'm bored. Come on, scoot. Ain't gonna wait forever.
Okay, yeah. I'd like a ride. That'd be good. Thanks.
Hell yeah! Get in! Let's tear it up!
I'm trying to get to my gran's house.
Fuck, she liked to party? Just get in. We'll get there. Or somewhere. Eventually.
Name's Nate, by the way. Thanks for asking. You thirsty?
Here you go.
I'm straight, thanks.
You're not uptight, are you? Because this is the fucking apocalypse. This is like nothing.
No, I'm just good, all right?
All right, all right. You want to tell me about where you come from, at least? You must have been with a crew. Any tail back where you come from? Maybe drop you off, do a double back.
No tail.
Damn. I retract my question.
There was a girl who I liked, all right.
You're arguing semantics, Russ. Give a pal the deets.
All right. There was 7 of us. I didn't have any family there or nothing. They were all at my grand's down in Statesboro. There was a dad who had a daughter about my age. One guy said he used to be a cop, but nobody really believed him. Then a teacher and his wife. Leader was this guy. Steve.
Go back to the daughter.
Steve was a bad dude, but everybody was with him, you know? He said 7 was the magic number, so we didn't add nobody to the group. If we found survivors, it was the same every time. He...
Let it out, Paco.
Just... We gonna kill these folks and take their stuff or what? Then bang! They'd be dead. Anyway, couldn't handle that. After weeks of it, I packed my shit up and figured I could make for grand's alone and try to find my family. I slipped out of there. I couldn't live like that.
So nobody got down with the daughter then?
No, they didn't.
What would you give her? Strong 6? Just tell me something about her. How was the rack? Give me a little something. Just a taste. Russ, I'm doing you a service here. I gotta get my beak wet. I'll put it right in here.
Sure, whatever.
Sure, whatever? Come on. All right, maybe someone who wasn't so near and dear to your heart then.
What the fuck?
Come on, scale it 1 to 10.
What do you think? Slamming before she was rocked, right?
What do you think? Here, get a look.
Fuck!
Like the knife, right?
Get off me!
Maybe you got high standards.
Help!
If you say five, I'm gonna flip.
Five!
Tell me, Russ!
Five! Fucking five!
Oh, come on, man!
You load that? Bullets in the glove there.
Let's look for some supplies in here. See if we can fill up while we're at it. Don't be mad. Fine, be mad. Just stop being a pussy.
I...
Oh, shit! Go! Get out!
Russ! Get the fuck down, man! You don't want to be there! Get to the truck! I'll cover you!
Okay, get ready!
Don't stop running! And keep your head down!
Good, Huss.
What happened to I'll cover you?
Look how good you did.
All right. What are we gonna do?
First, we're gonna figure out exactly where this asshole is. Just get a quick glance.
Down!
See? Easy. Now we know where he is, we can fucking get him.
All right. Yeah.
That's the spirit. Let's push this truck for cover.
Okay.
It's in neutral. Just keep your head down. Just keep pushing! Shit! Push! End of the road.
What now?
We're gonna get around the side of the building. We gotta go from cover to cover. Seriously, this time. I'm not fucking around.
Yeah, no problem. Easy as pie.
Just don't get shot. If we get to that car, we'll be out of the line of fire. Here. You can cover me first. I'm not fucking around. You cover me, then I'll cover you. Well, if you want to go first, that's fine too.
I'll cover you. You go first.
Just shoot at the window and keep that fucker's head down till I get where I'm going. Then throw me the gun, and I'll do the same. Ready?
Yeah.
You ready, Russ? Cover my ass now. Remember, don't stop shooting. Fire!
All right, throw me the gun and I'll cover you.
Go! Good job!
Now what?
We get over there and we should be good. Go!
Thanks.
We're not done yet. Let's see if we can get in around back. Sneak up on this asshole. Follow me.
Man, what are we doing?
Well, we gotta get in there. Fucker shot at us. Russell, relax, man. When this is over, we're gonna take what we can, head on down to your Gram's, and have a big ol' home-cooked meal, alright? Come on.
Okay, it's clear. Keep your head down and follow me, you got it. Alright, we're gonna be fucking quiet. We're gonna sneak up on this son of a bitch and take him out. You hear me? Not a fucking peep. Let's go. I see him. Check through the window. See if there's anyone else.
I think I saw a guy.
Shit. Grab him. I'll cover you.
Do I sneak up? Just jump out and grab him.
Your call.
Here, you monsters!
Whoa, Gramps!
I told you not to come back here! Think you could just leave your mask at home? And now you're with this fucking spook!
First off, watch the fucking racism. This is my boy. Secondly, I don't fucking know you. We were just passing by like anyone else.
Bullshit! You came back to finish us off and take all our food!
You've lost your goddamn marbles.
She's dying, and now she can see your face.
Shut up.
She can see who took her from me.
Shut this guy up. I can't handle this.
Agreed. Look at how much progress we've made. You tried to kill us for no goddamn reason. If anything, we should take you out for that.
Please just get the fuck out of here. Please leave us alone.
What do you say, Russ? Should we just kill these folks and take all their stuff?
Why?
All right, look at all this shit. See? Worth dodging some bullets?
What the?
Relax. You're my boy, Russell. Things are gonna be A-okay.
We were right. There are survivors out here.
Still alive? Oh, they're gonna be happy to get rescued. So how many are we talking about?
Around 5, I think. They left a note, so at least we know they want to be found. And I can see smoke in the distance. Probably a camp. I'm gonna try to make contact tonight.
Great. Well, just be careful and use your best judgment. Building a good community here, we want to keep it that way.
Of course. So good. I'm gonna try to talk to him. Wish me luck.
Yeah, good luck. Be careful. Don't try to force him into anything. Just get as many of them as you can.
You got it. Hey! Don't shoot!
Vince! Don't fucking move! Who the fuck are you?
My name is Tavia.
How did you find us?
I follow the smoke. I'm a scout for a growing settlement up north. We go out and look for survivors to rescue them. We have food, clean water, and shelter for everyone. We're offering you a chance to help us out and start over.
God, this sounds too good to be true, but I think it is.
Bonnie, get real. Just because you have to tell the truth all the time doesn't mean everyone else does.
If I didn't trust people, I'd be dead. I know that for sure. People can care about you if you let them.
Like Leland cared when he let you run off alone.
That's enough, Becca. I heard rumors about these places. This guy I was traveling with ditched me trying to find one on his own. He thought, you know what? Let's do this. She looks well fed, right? And clean? We could all use a meal and a hot shower.
Wait, you find survivors? Do you find a lot?
Not as many anymore, but...
Well, we gotta go. Eddie might be there.
Wyatt.
Look, we need people. Plain and simple. You folks can decide if you want to come as a group, or split up, or whatever. But I don't want to be out here in the open after dark. So in a few minutes, I'm gonna be getting back in my car and on my way. Hopefully, at least some of you will follow me.
Chell, why are we even listening to her? She's obviously lying.
Even if she's not, I think it's better to just keep on the move. Staying in one place makes you an easy target. I don't care how safe you think it is.
That truck stop was a death trap. It was right off the highway, for God's sake. No way you and a bunch of sick old people were gonna defend it. No, fuck this. She's crazy. I don't trust her.
Of course you don't, Russell. You don't trust anyone.
I'm not lying to you.
How do we know that?
You don't. You don't have to come, but we'd be happy to have you.
I don't understand what the problem is. Are you really considering staying out here? Foraging for food like fucking raccoons? I mean, then why did we even leave the photos there?
Well, it could be a trap. What if they want to kill us?
Thank you. Everyone out there is batshit crazy. We've all seen it.
Well, we turned out all right, didn't we?
Relatively speaking.
You clearly outnumber me. If you wanted to overpower me, you could. Hell, I'll even go along as your hostage until you feel safe. No one is gonna hurt you.
That's not a bad idea, actually.
And I'll do it. Because I know when you guys see this place, you'll change your minds. Look, I know you guys are wary, and you have every right to be. You don't know me from a hole in the ground. And yeah, there are some crazy fuckers out there. All I'm here to do is make an offer. You can come with me, or you can stay here. The choice is yours. So, who wants to come with me?
Yeah. I'm going.
Yeah, I have to.
I'm just not sure. We've been out here for so long and seen so much bullshit. I mean, is it really worth getting our hopes up?
Of course it is, Russell. Hope is all we've got left.
But being smart, that's what's keeping us alive.
Some of you may have been separated from friends or family. It's a long shot, but there's a chance you could find them there.
Have your people been through Statesboro?
Yes, I think we have.
Okay, but I swear to God, if you try anything, you're gonna regret it.
We'll do everything we can to help you find your friends and family. But understand that I can't promise anything.
We understand. I think we've all made up our minds.
Well, I guess we have our group. What do you want to do with these?
This is a good thing. I know it is.
How do we know this will work out?
What's the alternative? Staying out here?
Old School Gamer 1971 back with his thoughts on The Walking Dead Season 1 by Telltale Games, released in 2012 for the PS3, 2014 for the PS4, and 2017 for the HD collection. This has been the version I have been playing. I think it is around my 6th playthrough, but I will give you my thoughts of plot and improvements. So off the bat, the graphical overall is amazing. It looks so much better and runs so much smoother. It was cool to see Glenn and see characters who weren't in the later seasons. I didn't remember Kenny being as hard-assed as he is. I found that the Carly and Lily confrontation was also quite hard. I'd forgot how much dialogue there was in the game. Their interactions was good, if a little limited. I remember not seeing the Lee being bitten thing coming, and the man who took Clem being the owner of the car they had stole from earlier, not on the first time through for definite. I was a complete shock the first time through. The head in the bag is such a real nice touch, because I suppose in a way you could possibly see the guy's point of view until the moment you look at the head in the bag, and then you begin to understand, and as well him suggesting that him and Clem could start a new family was also a very creepy thing. I also felt that the final scene with Lee was very, very well put together. I can remember sitting there hoping that there was a way around this, that maybe he caught it in time and all of this was just blood loss, but no, it was so well put together and a really good ending. So on to 400 Days. That fits rather snugly between Season 1 and Season 2 with characters you may meet during Season 2. You also see Carly's corpse along the road. I remember sitting there hoping that yet again she had been shot but she hadn't been killed, but no such luck. As with the first season and almost all Telltale games, there is characters you like and some you hate, and some just don't seem to matter at all. It was cool to see the different characters' story arc being at different points of the infection, hence the name 400 Days. I am so glad that they put together the collection. I got this as part of the final season pre-order, which made it amazing value. A couple of days ago it was announced that Skybound had taken over the game's last two episodes, so we will have an ending to this season. As you probably notice, I left my death sim, so it will be a far from perfect playthrough, and I will live react to the final season. If you've enjoyed this video or the others before, like, subscribe or comment, it will be really appreciated. Bye Millie, bye Lloyd, bye everyone, and I look forward to seeing you in the second season.